The Calgary country duo Leaving Thomas is on fire right now. Their debut EP, released back in January, topped the iTunes country charts, hitting number one on the first day of its release. And now they're hoping to win a major contest that could take the band to the next level. Annika Odegaard and Brighton Udy are joining me this morning. Good morning to both of you.
Morning.
This is a very exciting time for you guys, right? Like, I'm feeling this energy coming off of you guys.
Absolutely.
For sure. Yeah. So first of all, tell me about the name Leaving Thomas. What's going on there? Why did you choose that name?
Well, my name is Annika and his name is Brighton, and we've been performing as a duo for about 3.5 years. But when we were first starting out, we would just introduce ourselves as Annika and Brighton, but people mispronounced it. We got every name under the sun: Erica and Brian, Akina and Brighton. And so eventually we were like, we want our names to be part of it, but we also want people to pronounce it.
Yeah, we also wanted it to be like personal to us still.
Sure.
And still have a meaning for us. So one day I asked Annika what her middle name was, and she said it was Leave, and my middle name is Thomas. And so it's L-I-V, because it's Norwegian, but so
right.
We changed up the spelling, so it's actually Leaving Thomas, and people can pronounce it, but
yes.
Yeah.
And it works.
It works.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
So tell me just a little bit about your sound. I was watching these videos yesterday, and I was really intrigued, because it was country, but not country, right? Like, it's kind of got
right.
this blues vibe, and it, yeah, so tell me a little bit about your sound.
Well, yeah, we started off by saying we were on the fringes of country,
mm-hmm.
and then, you know, as Brighton and I kind of wrote songs together, we realized we both grew up listening to country. We both love the stories that country music,
yes.
you know, tells. And so we thought, well, how do we combine our sound and our musical backgrounds? I come from, I worked on cruise ships for 4 years as a piano bar entertainer. Brighton grew up playing guitar, so we decided to basically meld those together. And we were both doing solo artist mm-hmm. stuff for a while, but the sound that we created together was something that people just, you know, were drawn to, and it snowballed from there, and now here we are. So we kind of say pop country.
Yeah.
You know, some right. like some 80s influence, some
yeah.
blues influences, and
there
we're just
is.
Kind of like bringing our own style to that country genre.
Right. Well, it sounds fantastic. Tell us a little bit about this video in particular, Blame It on the Neon.
Yeah, so we actually shot this one at Knoxville's in Calgary.
Yeah, I was like, isn't that in Calgary?
Yeah,
yeah.
Absolutely. So it was a lot of fun, because we were able to bring out some fans and kind of put out a little call out. And that was our buddy Austin, who's actually a bartender, so he knew what he was doing
oh,
back
nice.
There.
Yes.
And so, yeah, we just kind of wanted to tell a story within the song. And if you watch the beginning, Annika walks in. And
yeah, you guys are goofy.
We walk in and
it's
are
cute.
Goofy, and then during the song, we kind of become the rock stars.
Yes.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
And it was our first video that we actually got to kind of help produce
yeah.
and come
yeah.
up with the treatment. And we always want to bring a little bit of comedy.
For
to,
sure.
I think people take themselves so seriously, and we are just goofballs. So that's kind of the bumper on the beginning and the
yeah,
end.
Yeah, I saw that. It was really cute. It was very cute. Okay, so we need to get to this competition. So this is a competition that could really take your careers to the next level, couldn't it? Okay,
yes.
So tell us all about it.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are in the SiriusXM Top of the Country contest, and there's 9 contestants right now across the entire country, 3 in each region, and we are in the Western region, and actually the only Albertans.
Oh!
So we're hoping we can
there you go,
get
guys.
All of Alberta's vote.
Yes.
And the top 3 actually move on to compete at the SiriusXM CCMA showcase event, where we get to we would open for a headlining artist, and then be chosen to move on, and we could win $25,000 and performance opportunities and songwriting opportunities in Nashville and throughout Canada as well.
A lot of opportunity could come from
yeah.
this.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Okay, well, best of luck to both of you.
Thank you.
We've got our votes for
yes.
you guys
yeah.
going
Thank
in.
Thank you so much for having us.
You bet. Thanks for being here. We're going to go for a break here on Breakfast Television. When we come back, we have news, weather, and traffic. Stay right there.